Starlight Casinos, you are on screen. Your look into the world of film and television, brought to you by the Starlight Casino in New Westminster.
Welcome back to the show. If you know anything about Miss Forbes and I, it's that you know we love So You Think You Can Dance.
We
Canada.
Do, because we can't dance.
Yeah.
We like to watch other people do it who can. We are joined now by someone who will be very familiar to you, Luther Brown from So You Think You Can Dance Canada. How are you? How are you?
I'm good. I'm good.
I think that is part of the attraction of the show for a lot of people, is that there's no way I'm going to have the ability in my lifetime, in this body, to do some of the things that these dancers can do. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's really crazy. I think it's like it's the first time you really get to see people push to their limits and just throw new things that they have to adapt.
And it's so amazing
right now
what this show has done for dance, because it really is something so kids can watch it. They can see that they can have a career in dance. Mm-hmm. They can have something to look up to. What is it like for you to have this forum for dance?
I mean, it's amazing. It puts everything in everyone's home. First of all, it brings a lot of things that have been happening on the street or have been happening, but no one really knew about it. Yeah. It kind of puts it to the forefront, and it kind of brings everybody's job up.
What was it like for you when you were a young man? I mean, you're from Toronto originally, and Toronto's got it, you know, they've got a scene, but it's not, you know, it's not LA, it's not New York. So what was it like for you breaking in?
Man, it was, you know what, I kind of had to do it myself. It was one of those things where I didn't really have a set schedule or a set map. Yeah. You just did what you did, you know what I'm saying? And it just ended up working with different artists. And I did all these things without knowing what I was doing. Like, I didn't know.
That's the best way.
I didn't know I was a choreographer. I'm like, what's a choreographer? It's not like I grew up knowing, and that's a choreographer. And this is. So you just kind of do what you do, and naturally you meet the right people, and things just panned out.
And what was your big break into choreography?
My big break?
I mean, you've worked with such huge artists.
You know what? I think my friend, one of my best friends, Julie Black.
We love her.
Yeah. Like, we literally were, like, we lived right beside each other. And one day she was like, you know, you gotta put my show together. This is when we were like this in the basement. And so I put her show together, just, you know, dance routine. But I didn't know I was a choreographer. And just little by little, people saw her show, and everyone just started asking me to do their shows, and Michi, then Maestro, then I literally did everybody in Canada.
Well, and it's an amazing art form, because it is, you know, you can learn so much by watching other people.
Yeah.
And I think it's one of those rare things. I mean, I guess you can in music and stuff, but in dance it seems, you know, especially applicable that inspiration can come from the people that are around you. So
yeah, I mean, it's like you feed off of everything, you know? You feed off everything, and dance is such a thing. It's such a soul thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you go, and the more people that you're around, more people that are doing things around you, it kind of boosts you to do what you got to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so how does that transfer? I mean, when you come to a competition like So You Think You Can Dance Canada, how does that idea of soul translate to you as a judge? Can you sense that? Can you see someone?
I could totally see it. And that's why, you know, I laugh a lot. Because sometimes it's no soul.
There's some technique. Sometimes it's no technique.
Sometimes
there's
just absolutely no technique. But I think what it is like, you can tell. You can just tell when something or someone's good. Like, you can tell, like, you might not be the most technically trained, but you can see when someone just has a natural it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And what was it like when you guys met Nico? I mean, I think he's been the biggest success so far. When he came to our studio, it was obviously, you know, he's got that it factor. Yeah. But what was it like for you guys when you first met him and saw him dance?
The first time he came on the stage, and he didn't even get to go straight through. We put him through the choreography.
Really?
Yeah, but you can just tell. He just had this, I think it was probably one of the most confident personalities without being cocky.
Yeah.
He was that guy.
Tough thing to do, right?
Yeah, I mean, he was that guy. It's almost like he knew he was dope, but he wasn't really showing that he was dope, but it almost like he didn't care, but he was just dope. Yeah.
That's, you know how that is.
I totally understand what you're talking about. You've been traveling across Canada. Vancouver's your very last stop on the audition tour. Do you see different styles? I mean, are there different styles sort of coast
there
to coast?
There are I think because, you know, now the world is so, the dance is so big between YouTube and workshops, traveling, and people getting
people see
lessons,
the same influences.
Everybody is kind of morphing their style into someone else's style, and so it's like there's a lot of these new styles.
Yeah,
like there's a b-boy from Montreal.
Mm-hmm.
It's so crazy. It's so crazy because it's like he morphed a little bit of contemporary, but with some, I don't want to give it away, but it's.
Is that it's this year?
This That's, season.
Oh.
It's crazy. Like, literally, everybody's mouth is like.
Well, that must be so great, though, when you guys are blinded by talent that just is so raw.
Yeah, there's some, I think, I mean, and I'm sure everybody says that every season, but really, this season, so far, I mean, yes, there's been some corny kids.
But those are fun for the audience.
But it's going to happen.
But there's some really interesting, strong personalities.
Mm-hmm. When you're on the show, whether you're judging or whether you're doing choreography, do you enjoy getting people that have a different background and teaching them something about your passion and hip-hop? Or do you like people that come from that hip-hop background?
I mean, it's kind of half and half, because as a choreographer, you want somebody that understands your language already, because, you know, the time that you get to work with them is this much. So sometimes you do want the you know, people that are well versed in what you do so that you can get them to where they got to get quicker.
Right.
Yeah.
But, like, for example, Jeff from the season, you know, totally not in the same planet that I was from, but it was so much fun because he was like a sponge.
Right. Yeah.
So you kind of get to see him grow.
Yeah, you know, well, and get them understanding it, right? I mean, if they come from a contemporary or a ballet background, whatever it is, but to have them open their eyes to this whole new form
it's really cool.
Like watching someone be reborn. And
it's really cool. it's just so many experiences. That's really cool.
Okay, for those who are coming out to the auditions here in Vancouver that are tomorrow, what do you look for? How should people prepare? What should they not do?
Okay, first of all, don't be one particular style and then think that you're gonna just miraculously become a ballroom dancer the day of your audition. Like, do what you do. Don't come here trying to show us that you're well-versed, because that's not what we're looking for the first day. We just want to see who you are and how dope you are and what special tricks you have and how much you love it. You know what I'm saying? Because you'll be so surprised. People come on the show and they do something that they never do.
Yeah.
Like, why are you trying to do that flip if you never flip? Why are you doing that? Why are you trying to be lyrical
and
that's not what you do?
You guys are honest.
Do
like
what
that.
You do. Do what you do so we can appreciate it. And, you know, because we all want to get hype. I want to get hype.
Yeah, well, and we've been saying, you know, you've mentioned it a couple times, and we've heard this from other judges as well. You know, you guys are really good at sensing whether someone sort of has it, whether they have that spark as well. So.
Yeah, and if you're a judge and you're not good at that, maybe you shouldn't be a judge.
So have you seen some shining stars along the way? Because Vancouver's your last stop.
Yeah, it's funny because after every city, I mean, on top of drawing sketches and little happy faces and stuff on the desk, I also put down who I think in my head is gonna be top 20. And so at first you're like, okay, I'm sure this is what it is. And then you get to another city and you're like,
and the list changes.
The list kind of changes. And it's been it's the longest list I've had for a long time.
That's great to hear.
And have you been accurate most years?
Yes, I have.
He's
all right, one last question about tomorrow. Would you rather see me show up in tights or shorts?
I don't know.
Do
what
if
I do.
Tights make you
tights
feel,
it is.
If tights makes you feel good,
you
then
to
do
drop
what
in
it is.
At Luther again. Come on. He was doing it in the green room. It was awesome. So You Think You Can Dance Canada. Auditions for Vancouver are tomorrow. Registration is at 9 a.m. at the Centre in Vancouver. Do what's good for you. Just do something. Take his advice. So check it out.
Yeah, and we're looking forward to another great season.
Absolutely.
Just a tremendous show all the way
through. It's going to be amazing.
Thank you, man.